Today we're going to talk about brake fluid. We're going to talk about the types of brake fluid, what to do if your brake fluid level is low, and also how to test your brake fluid. Brake fluid plays a very important part in the braking system. It actually transfers that hydraulic pressure to mechanical movement to actually apply the brake pads against the rotor or apply the brake shoes against the drum. The first step in inspection is to actually look at the fluid level. Now, in this case, it's a clear plastic reservoir, so I can see the fluid level. Sometimes it's a cast iron or black plastic, you can't see through it, so you have to physically take the cap off to look at the brake fluid. I personally like to take the cap off anyways to always look to see if this rubber gasket is distorted. If this rubber gasket gets distorted, that means that somebody put petroleum-based fluid or oil into the brake fluid. Now, as you can see, the power steering reservoir is right here. So, you know, possibly somebody put, if somebody did put power steering fluid in here, that contamination would cause all the rubber seals to expand. Once all those seals expand, you develop leaks and problems, and the whole brake system has to be overhauled. Okay, so we've taken a sample of brake fluid out of the master cylinder. Now we're going to test it. Now there's a few different tests we can do. One of them is copper content. Now the easiest way to do the copper content is with these dip strips. Now what I would do is dip this into the brake fluid, watch the color change on this dip strip, and compare it to the container here. It tells me how much copper content is in my brake fluid. Copper content is telling me how much copper is being removed off the brake lines. Too much copper content tells me that brake fluid has been in there way too long. Now another test I can do is moisture content. Now moisture content I can do with a tool like this. This tool right here actually gets put into the brake fluid, press the button, and it'll actually tell me what the moisture content of that brake fluid is. As you can see, 1% and 2% is okay. When it gets above 3 and 4%, that means there's way too much moisture in your brake fluid. Brake fluid is hygroscopic. It's always pulling moisture out of the air. If you get too much moisture in your brake fluid, your boiling point level lowers. If the boiling point level lowers, that means that your brake fluid can actually boil under hard braking conditions, causing a loss of brake pedal. There's one more test we can do, but this tool is pretty expensive for the average do-it-yourselfer. It's pretty much going to be at a professional repair shop. But what they'll do is they'll take a sample of brake fluid, they will dip this in there, hit the button, and this will actually heat this brake fluid and give the exact amount of moisture in that brake fluid. If your brake fluid level is low, you really only have two possibilities. One, you have a leak somewhere, or two, you've got worn down brake pads. As these brake pads wear down, the pistons come farther out of the caliper. Well, when the pistons come farther out of the caliper, it creates a void which is filled with the brake fluid from the master cylinder reservoir. That could be why your brake fluid level is a little bit low. Now, in that case, you do a brake job. But let's say you inspect your brakes and you find out the pads are not worn, and you're still losing brake fluid. In fact, you may be putting brake fluid in your system every so often. Well, that tells me then there's probably a leak somewhere. That means I have to really do a good inspection on all my brake lines, brake hoses, the caliper itself could be leaking, the wheel cylinders could be leaking, even the master cylinder could be leaking. So you really want to look at all points where the hydraulic fluid is, where brake fluid is, and look for that leak. Okay, there's different types of brake fluid out there. There's .3, there's .4, there's .5.1. All of those are glycol-based, .3 being probably the most common. But there's also things like silicone brake fluid that's synthetic-based, .5 these are called right here. But really, you're going to look at the cap of the master cylinder. In this case, it says to use .3, so we're going to put the .3 in here. Now, it's not always written on the cap. Sometimes you'll have to look in the owner's manual or go online and check out the service information. Either way, put the correct brake fluid in the vehicle. Now, if you did repair a brake line or brake hose on this vehicle, and that's why your brake fluid level was low, you've got to bleed the brakes. Check out our video on bleeding brakes also.